Good afternoon, everyone. As William Blake says, sound the flute, now it's mute. Birds delight, day and night. Nightingale in the dale, lark in the sky. Merrily, 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 to welcome in the year. As William Blake, the renowned poet of poetry of love, welcomes the spring, the monarch of all seasons. I, Dr. Niranjana Malani, welcome you all to this delightful Spring Poetry Festival. As curtain raiser, let me tell you that soon you are going to relish verses that would give you an experience of this most spectacular season of all. The Spring Poetry Festival, or Basant Kavya Mahotsav, is being organized by the Department of English, Government Girls PG College, Ujjain, in collaboration with IQSE and Tapan Chaure Foundation, Ujjain. It is indeed a pleasure to have you all with us this afternoon. This is indeed my proud privilege to invite at the very outset Dr. Neeta Tapan, Coordinator, IQSE, Government Girls PG College, Ujjain, and President of Tapan Chaure Foundation, to bring to you the context of this event. Over to you, ma'am.
जो तुम आ जाते एक बार, कितनी करुणा, कितने संदेश, पथ में बिज जाते बन पराग, गाता प्राणों का तार तार, अनुराग भरा उन्माद राग, आंसू लेते ये पथ पखार, जो तुम आ जाते एक बार, हंस उठते पल में आर्द्र नयन, धुल जाता होठों से विषाद, छा जाता जीवन में बसंत, लुट जाता चिर संचित विराग, आंखें देती सर्वस्व वार, जो तुम आ जाते एक बार, बिखरे केश सज जाते, लग जाते जूड़े में पलाश, जो तुम आ जाते एक बार। बसंत मात्र एक ऋतु नहीं, आशा है, प्रेम है, सौंदर्य है, विरह में प्रतीक्षा है, मिलन है, सृजन है। बसंत पंचमी पर आज बसंत काव्य महोत्सव में आप सभी का स्वागत है। इस महोत्सव का संदर्भ है बसंत और पतझड़ में भी बसंत का गीत गाती एक शिक्षक की पुण्यतिथि, जो साहित्य साधना, अंग्रेजी हिंदी में लेखन और आजीवन हर भूमिका में प्रेम करने में रत रहीं। 3 दशकों से अधिक तक शासकीय कन्या स्नातकोत्तर महाविद्यालय उज्जैन के अंग्रेजी विभाग में प्राध्यापक रही प्रोफेसर सरला डेविड, उनकी जिज्ञासा उनकी लिखी पुस्तक जीवन मंथन में और उसके कवर पेज पर धरती की तड़कती छाती में उग आए नव अंकुर में साफ झलकती है। Born in 1936, having joined Government Girls PG College, Ujjain in 1961, and having retired in 1993, Professor Sarla David served in the English department of this college throughout her career for 32 long years. As a Rajput girl, remaining confined to domestic boundaries in her youth, behind veil, she struggled her way to higher education in the 1950s. Made it to the career of teaching as a professor of English, rebelled to culminate her love into an inter-religious marriage and treaded on the chosen path undeterred. An epitome of simplicity and empowerment, she was a woman who relentlessly carved her own paintings of spring on the canvas of life, a teacher who ardently played the flute of prose and poetry to her students, a person who defiantly planted her own daffodils and tulips in the autumn of life, who lived life with an extraordinary grit and subsided into the everlasting tranquility on 16th February 2020, leaving behind trails of hope and resilience for those who, in the midst of a seemingly endless winter, try to discover within themselves an invincible spring. We, the staff, students, and the alumni of Government Girls PG College, Ujjain, celebrate the Spring Poetry Festival to pay an ode to the beloved professor of this college with a medley of English, Hindi, and Sanskrit poetry. I conclude with a small poem written by Professor Sarla David to set the stage. The symphony of nature, the flutes of birds, the dancing butterflies, the chorus of winds, the nodding trees, the clapping flowers, the fragrant pollens, the swaying grass, the glittering stage, all bowing to the baton of Maestro Sun, as I watch in astonishment the orchestra of spring striking the chords of Allegro. Thank you. Back to Dr. Niranjana Malani.
Thank you very much, ma'am. And now I would like to request our Honorable Head of the English Department and Officiating Principal, Dr. Hemant Gehlot, to share the concept note of this festival. It is always a great pleasure to listen to his discourse, and today he is going to benefit us by his pragmatic observations on the conceptual framework of this event. Before inviting him, I am unable to stop myself by saying few words for him. He is open-minded and a rare combination of simplicity and magnificence. He has been the source of all energy, undivided attention, articulation, ever welcoming attitude and positivity, which has touched our lives. As spring flourishes the nature, literature flourishes in his hands. Over to you, sir.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed a pleasure to present the concept note of this vibrant spring poetry festival. Spring is a season of growth and rejuvenation in all walks of life. Although nature is life's blood of humanity on earth, and its various shades affect human life in overt as well as covert manner. Literature in all languages profusely celebrated the seasons. All the more, the king of all seasons, that is spring. We are celebrating advent of spring in the form of Basant Panchami, and there can be no other occasion to turn to poetry than spring. Hindi, English, and Sanskrit are the three languages with which we can assume that we are familiar in this region. And literature of these languages are pregnant with poetry that celebrates spring in all its colors and shades and shapes. I cannot resist quoting Wordsworth's lines from Lines Written in Early Spring that beautifully depicts the depth of the season in just four lines filled with meanings that go beyond the human senses. I quote, "The primrose tufts in that green bower, the periwinkle trails in reeds, and it is my faith that every flower enjoys the air it breathes." Such was the power of belief in nature that Wordsworth could not disengage himself from the flowers that also epitomized life on earth. Beginning with Chaucer, the father of English literature, the spring has been fascinating one and all, for it is so profusely suffused with life that it thrills the imagination to the seventh cloud. And Christina Rossetti, one of the best known romantics, proclaims, "There is no time like spring when life is alive in everything." Whether it is Hindi poetry of Nirala or Pant, or Sanskrit poetry like the epic Ritusamha written by Kalidas, spring finds a proud place that is very close to the heart of the sensitive souls. This is a world phenomenon that lovers, lunatics, and poets are similar in many characteristics and have been immensely adopted to the tune of lyrical compositions. This is going to be a feat that will be remembered long. With the perspective in the mind, the PG Department of English, in collaboration with the Pancharya Foundation and IQSC headed by Dr. Neeta Thappan, aspired to bring together the creative acumen of students and poets for the benefit of deaf audiences across the globe. As an added significance, this event is commemorating the fond memory of our late Professor Lajavit, whose 3 decades of teaching stint in this institution had set the highest norms of mentor-pupil tradition, which still nurture the academic atmosphere in the department. With this concept note, I hand over the session back to Dr. Anjana Malani to proceed ahead with the poetry recitation session. Over to you, Naranjana. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Now we move ahead with our program and we go into the most awaited segment of this program, where we will listen to some of the magnificent poetry on the ever-refreshing spring season. The galaxy of poetry brought to you includes poems by celebrated authors, and some of them are also self-composed. India is a multilingual country, and so is our festival today. You will be delighted to listen this poetic extravaganza in as well as in Sanskrit. The poetry recital session will be conducted by Mr. Nitin David and Ms. Ulja Thappan from Thappanchorey Foundation. Over to you, sir, and Ulja.
Thank you, ma'am. It is spring again now. The earth is like a child who knows poems by heart. Welcome to the Spring Poetry Festival. All began in love. All seeks to return in love. Love is the law that binds the teacher and the student. The teacher takes a hand, opens a mind, touches a heart, and creates an eternal spring season of learning. So what a teacher leaves behind is not what is engraved in stone monuments, but what is entwined into the lives of others and lifelong learning. This love comes back to Professor Sarla David from her exceptionally brilliant student from 1983 batch, Ms. Prateeksha Pawar, a connoisseur of art and literature and a magical teacher herself. She gives a tribute to her teacher, David Madam, with her feelings woven into her self-composed poem. Over to Ms. Prateeksha Pawar. Madam Prateeksha.
A very warm good evening to all the learned members linked to the StreamYard. I'm Prateeksha Pawar, and I was fortunate to have a teacher like David Madam. It is said that a good professor constructs you. We seldom realize the lasting influence of our teachers in our lives. We are what we are because of the efforts of our erudite and revered professors. Today, with a sense of deep gratitude, I wish to recite a poem composed in the fond memory of my iconic English professor, David Madam. unheard melodies she played, of man's imagination supreme, from the Hellenic to the atomic. Unrolled before us, classic, new, strange, an endless fountain of immortal drink, pouring unto us from the heaven's brink. Prose, crisp, poetry, lyrical, fiction, enchanting, plays, reforming. Drink deep, quoth she, or taste not the Pyrian spring. Thoughts profound, humor subtle, tragedy dark, mysteries cryptic, adventures riveting, full of sound and fury. All shades of human experience, emotions, thoughts. Her soft voice recounted from the realms of gold, distant lands, exotic climes, unknown cultures, unfamiliar people, bygone times. Their wealth she unraveled as the sun brings to light Earth's myriad hues for us to know some eternal universal truths. While we, like stout courtesans men, looked at each other with a wild surmise, silent upon a peak in Darien. Thank you.
श्री अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी जी ने लिखा, टूटे हुए तारों से फूटे बासंती स्वर, पत्थर की छाती में उगाया नव अंकुर, झरे सब पीले पात, कोयल की कुहक रात, प्राची में अरुणिम की रेख देख पता हूं, गीत नया गाता हूं। इस बसंत काव्य महोत्सव में आपका पुनः स्वागत। एक कविता लिखनी थी मुझे, कहानी अंत और आरंभ की, सृष्टि के प्रारंभ की, बसंत की बहार की, जगत के आधार की। जब पूरी हुई तो बन गई कविता एक स्त्री पर, स्त्री और पृथ्वी, बसंत और प्रकृति जैसे पर्यायवाची। सुनेंगे उनकी स्वयं की लिखी कविता डॉक्टर शशि जोशी से, जो इस महाविद्यालय की पूर्व छात्रा हैं और वर्तमान में माधव विज्ञान महाविद्यालय उज्जैन में हिंदी की प्राध्यापक है। मैं आमंत्रित करता हूं डॉक्टर शशि जोशी।
मेरे आदरणीय प्रोफेसर हेमंत गहलोत एवं प्रोफेसर नीता तपन का फोन आया कि मुझे वसंत काव्योत्सव में शामिल होना है, तो इस महाविद्यालय के कई वसंत मेरी स्मृति और जेहन से गुजर गए। मैं यहाँ की पूर्व छात्रा तो हूँ ही, 14 वर्ष तक मैंने यहाँ अध्यापन भी किया है। मैं प्रोफेसर अनिता मनचंदिया प्राचार्य शासकीय कन्या स्नातकोत्तर महाविद्यालय उज्जैन, IQAC प्रभारी प्रोफेसर नीता तपन एवं कार्यक्रम के संयोजक प्रोफेसर हेमंत गहलोत को धन्यवाद देती हूँ कि उन्होंने शासकीय कन्या स्नातकोत्तर महाविद्यालय उज्जैन एवं तपन चौरे फाउंडेशन के संयुक्त तत्वाधान में आयोजित इस वसंत काव्योत्सव में मुझे शामिल होने का अवसर दिया है। इस अवसर पर मैं प्रोफेसर सरला डेविड जी को भी नमन करती हूँ। आज सरस्वती का प्राकट्योत्सव है, इसलिए माँ सरस्वती के भी चरणों में प्रणाम करती हूँ। मेरी पहली कविता का शीर्षक है वसंत को रसती है वह, और यह कविता उन सभी महिलाओं के लिए है जो दिन भर घर में काम काज करती हैं, देखभाल करती हैं और हम उनके समर्पण और प्रेम भावना को समझ नहीं पाते। तो प्रारंभ करती हूं मैं। वसंत को रसती है वह, उसने देखा नहीं वर्षों से फूलों को, उसने देखा नहीं वर्षों से फूलों को, जी भर देखा नहीं आकाश। पक्षियों के समूह उसकी छत से कलरव करते, सिर ऊपर से गुजरते रहे। पक्षियों के समूह उसकी छत से कलरव करते, सिर ऊपर से गुजरते रहे, उसने सुनी नहीं उनकी आवाज। वह तो अल सुबह उठकर हटाती रही अंधेरे के पत्थर झाड़ झंकार। वह तो अल सुबह उठकर हटाती रही अंधेरे के पत्थर झाड़ झंकार, और बहने लगे दूध के स्रोत। हमें लगा सूर्योदय हो रहा है धरती पर, हमें लगा सूर्योदय हो रहा है धरती पर। बेतरतीब चीजों को जमाने की कोशिश करती रही, बेतरतीब चीजों को जमाने की कोशिश करती रही हर दिन की, बिखर न जाए जीवन। जब सब जगह पर मिल जाती चीजें सबको जो वे चाहते हैं, तो चटक फूल खिल जाते धरती पर, तो चटक फूल खिल जाते धरती पर। फिर चूल्हे में आग लगाती, खत बदाती अरहर की दाल, चावल और चपाती की गंध से भर जाती दोपहर और रात। फिर चूल्हे में आग लगाती, खत बदाती अरहर की दाल, चावल और चपाती की गंध से भर जाती दोपहर और रात। ठंडे जल के साथ तृप्त हो जाती आत्माएं, ठंडे जल के साथ तृप्त हो जाती आत्माएं, तो बसंती बयार बहने लगती धरती पर, तो बसंती बयार बहने लगती धरती पर। शाम से ही बाट देखती है वह, शाम से ही बाट देखती है वह, उसके आकाश में जो रात आएगी, उसमें जो सबसे चमकीला चांद है, उसे किसे सौंपना है। झिलमिलाते तारों की झोली किसके हाथ पर रखनी है, सपनों की चांदनी की चादर उड़ानी है किसे, सपनों की चांदनी की चादर उड़ानी है किसे। जब सब सो जाते हैं तब फिर जागती है वह सुबह के इंतजार में, सुबह से शाम तक इस यात्रा में उसके पैर थकते नहीं हैं, सुबह से शाम तक इस यात्रा में उसके पैर थकते नहीं हैं। दौड़ती रहती है वह कहीं भी सो जाती, जैसे सो जाती हवा कहीं किसी पत्ते पर, जैसे सो जाती हवा कहीं किसी पत्ते पर। हमें लगता है वह खास कुछ करती नहीं है, उसने देखा नहीं वसंत कई वर्षों से, उसने देखा नहीं वसंत कई वर्षों से, नहीं देखा जी भर आकाश। उसने देखा नहीं वसंत कई वर्षों से, जी भर देखा नहीं आकाश, पर वह वसंत को रसती है हमारे लिए, वह वसंत को रसती है हमारे लिए। मेरी दूसरी कविता का शीर्षक है अंतिम इच्छा। यह अंतिम इच्छा पृथ्वी की इच्छा है, उसका स्वप्न। वसंत पृथ्वी का स्वप्न है जो वह सृष्टि को सौंपना चाहती है। मैं उसकी इस इच्छा में सहभागी बनना चाहती हूँ। तो प्रस्तुत है अंतिम इच्छा। सोचती हूँ तुम्हें अंतिम समय चलते हुए मेरा बनाया हुआ पृथ्वी का टुकड़ा दूं, सोचती हूँ तुम्हें अंतिम समय चलते हुए मेरा बनाया हुआ पृथ्वी का टुकड़ा दूं। आदमी के चेहरे का भूखंड जिसमें दरख्त अपनी जड़ों को पृथ्वी में फैलाते हैं, जिसमें दरख्त अपनी जड़ों को पृथ्वी में फैलाते हों, और तुम्हारे घर उस आकाश के नीचे हो जो इतना ऊंचा नहीं हो कि तुम उड़ ही न सको, और तुम्हारे घर उस आकाश के नीचे हो जो इतना ऊंचा नहीं हो कि तुम उड़ ही न सको। पत्थरों के बीच बहता हुआ झरना, पत्थरों के बीच बहता हुआ झरना, और वह नाव जो सूर्यास्त के बाद भी तैरे समुद्र में, और वह नाव जो सूर्यास्त के बाद भी तेरे समुद्र में, एक वसंत के साथ हरी भरी पृथ्वी तुम्हें दे दूं, एक वसंत के साथ हरी भरी पृथ्वी तुम्हें दे दूं। धन्यवाद।
धन्यवाद मैडम। Spring begins with buds on the trees, and with the lighter evenings comes a new spirit of optimism. From Wordsworth to Shelley to Sarojini Naidu, poets have always been inspired by the search of new beginnings. This festival celebrates some of the classic poems about spring, nature, and hope, and of course, some excellent self-composed poems by the alumni. So if ever there was a spring so perfect, so uplifted by a warm intermittent breeze, that it made you want to throw open all the windows in the house and unlatch the door to a lovebird's cage. Indeed, rip the little door from its jamb, then it is certainly the spring of Miss Vrinda's self-composed poem, who is an alumnus of Government Girls PG College, Ujjain, running an academy of English. Be prepared to be mesmerized with the incredible nature with Miss Vrinda Pawar. Over to you, madam. Ma'am, kindly unmute yourself.
Ma'am, please unmute your mic.
Good evening, all. It's a great honor and privilege for me to pay tribute to our most respected and legendary David ma'am. I'll recite my poem and share a PPT for a visual appeal. The title of my poem is Incredible Nature. The incredible nature mesmerizes me. The blooming flowers, the fragrance around, the bountiful pansies, the unfurling roses, the vivid and vibrant flora. The incredible nature mesmerizes me. The lush green meadows, the glistening trees, the myriad bushes, the flowering shrubs, the captivating wilderness, the incredible nature mesmerizes me. The cascading water, the rippling sound, the serpentine rivulet, the gushing and splashing water around, the calm and soothing lakes, the incredible nature mesmerizes me. The robust pigeons, the chirping and tweeting birds, the singing cuckoos, the flitting butterflies, the humming bees, the incredible nature mesmerizes me. The hues and tints of twilight, the gleaming sunshine, the alluring dawn, the bewildering dusk, the miraculous splendor of the rising sun, the incredible nature mesmerizes me and whispers into my ears, the spring is here. Thank you very much.
प्रेम हर सिंगार का निशब्द निशा में चुपके से झरने जैसा होता है। प्रेम कड़ी धूप में गुलमोहर का और सुर्ख होकर खिलखिलाने जैसा होता है। प्रेम ओस की बूंद का पत्ती की नोक पर जगमगाने जैसा होता है। प्रेम धूप पर सवार रंगों को समेट तस्वीर बनाने जैसा होता है। प्रेम बसंत के विश्वास में पतझड़ में पत्ते गिरा देने जैसा होता है। उमेश कुमार की इस कविता में प्रेम और बसंत सजीव हो उठते हैं। ऋतु संहार महाकवि कालिदास की प्रथम काव्य रचना जिसमें ग्रीष्म वर्षा शरद हेमंत शिशिर और बसंत इन छह ऋतुओं में कवि भारत के प्राकृतिक वैभव तथा जैव विविधता के परिवर्तनों के प्रणय जीवन पर पड़ने वाले प्रभावों का वर्णन अपनी प्रेयसी से करता है, जिसका एक अंश सुनेंगे हम डॉक्टर पूजा उपाध्याय से, जो महर्षि पाणिनि संस्कृत वैदिक विश्वविद्यालय के विशिष्ट संस्कृत विभाग में सहायक आचार्य। ओवर टू यू डॉक्टर पूजा उपाध्याय।
धन्यवादाः। वाग्देव्यै सरस्वती नमः। अद्य सरस्वती पूजनस्यापि विधानं वर्तते। सर्वेभ्यः अभिनन्दनानि। सर्वादौ आदरणीयाय तपन महोदयाय प्रणमामि, अथ च सरला डेविड महोदयायाः कृते अपि कार्तज्ञं, तेषामपि तेषां कृते अपि प्रणामाम् प्रणामाः मम पक्षतः वर्तन्ते। शासकीय कन्या स्नातकोत्तर महाविद्यालयस्य प्राचार्य महोदया अथ च अस्य कार्यक्रमस्य ये संयोजकाः वर्तन्ते, हेमंत महोदयाः, डॉक्टर नीता तपन महोदयायाः कृते, अन्य ये समेपि अत्र संयुक्ताः वर्तन्ते, समेषां कृते कार्तज्ञं विज्ञापयामि यत् ते अस्मिन् कार्यक्रमे माम् आहूतवन्तः। अहम् कालिदास विरचित ऋतु संहारात् कतिचन पद्यानि अत्र श्रावयामि। महाकविना ऋतु संहारे षड् ऋतूनां वर्णनं कृतं, ततः वसंत वर्णनं प्रस्तौमि। प्रफुल्ल चूताङ्कुर तीक्ष्ण सायको द्विरेफमाला विसद्धनुर्गुणः मनांसि भेत्तुं सुरत प्रसंगिनां वसंत योद्धा समुपागतः प्रिये। द्रुमाः सपुष्पाः सलिलं सपद्मं स्त्रियः सकामाः पवनः सुगंधे सुखाः प्रदोषाः दिवसाश्च रम्याः सर्वं प्रिये चारुतरं वसन्ति। वापी जलानां मणिमेखलानां शशांकभासां प्रमदाजनानां चूतद्रुमाणां कुसुमान्वितानां ददाति सौभाग्यमयं वसन्तः। किं किं शुकैः शुकमुखच्छविभिर्न भिन्नं किं कर्णिकारकुसुमैर्न कृतं न दग्धं यत् कोकिलः पुनरयं मधुरैर्वचोभिः यूनां मनः सुवदनानिहितं निहन्ति आकंपयन् कुसुमिताः सहकार शाखा विस्तारयन् परभृतस्य वचांसि दिक्षु वायुर्विवाति हृदयानि हरन्नराणां निहार पात विगमात् सुभगे वसन्ते। आकंपितानि हृदयानि मनस्विनानां वातैः प्रफुल्ल सहकार कृतादिवासैः उत्कूजितैः परभृतस्य मदाकुलस्य श्रोत्रप्रियैर्मधुकरस्य च गीतनादैः रक्ताशोक विकल्पिता धर्मधुः मत्तत्विरेफस्वनः कुन्दापीड विशुद्ध दंत निकरः प्रोत्फुल्ल पद्माननः चूतामोद सुगंधि मंद पवनः श्रृंगार दीक्षा गुरुः कल्पांतं मदन प्रियो दिशतु वः पुष्पागमो मंगलम् मलय पवन विद्धः कोकिलालाप रम्यः सुरभि मधु निषेकाल्लब्ध गंध प्रबन्धः विविध मधुपयूथैर्वेष्ट्यमाना समन्तात् भवतु तव वसन्तः श्रेष्ठकालः सुखाय आम्री मञ्जुलमञ्जरी वरशरः सत्किंशुकं यद्धनुः ज्यायस्यालिकुलं कलङ्करहितं छत्रं सितांशुः सितम् मत्ते भो मलयानिलः परभृता यद्वन्दिनो लोकजित् सोऽयं वो वितरीतरीतु वितनु भद्रं वसन्तान्वितः
महाकविना अत्र वसंत वर्णनम प्रस्तुतम। महाकवि कहना चाह रहे हैं कि ये जो वसंत है उसमें आम्र मंजरी के तीक्ष्ण बाणों को लिए हुए भ्रमर माला की प्रत्यंचा को चढ़ाकर जो प्रेमी जन है उनके चित्त को भेदने के लिए वसंत के रूप में एक योद्धा उपस्थित हो गया है। हम जानते हैं कि कवि मानव मन की गहराइयों तक पहुंचते हैं और अपनी कल्पना और अनुभव से वे एक नवीन काव्य की सर्जना करते हैं। तो जिस तरह से यह मनोविज्ञान है वसंत ऋतु के आने पर जैसे प्रकृति नवीकृत हो रही है वैसे ही मानव का मन भी उल्लसित प्रफुल्लित हो रहा है उसी का वर्णन कवि ने इसमें किया है। वे कह रहे हैं कि जल में कमल खिले हैं वृक्ष पुष्पित हो गए हैं स्त्रियों में काम उद्दीप्त हो रहा है पवन सुगंधित हो गई है दिन भी रम्य है और रात भी रम्य है। वसंत ऐसा मौसम है ऐसी ऋतु है जहाँ दिन भी सुखकर है और रात भी सुखकर है चारों से चारों तरह है। जो किंशुक वृक्ष है उसके पत्ते झड़ गए हैं और वो फूलों से संपन्न हो गया है ऐसा दिखाई दे रहा है जैसे अग्नि प्रज्वलित हो रही है मानो वसंत रूपी प्रिय से मिलने के लिए जो धरती है उसने लाल साड़ी पहन ली है जैसे कि नव वधू होती है अपने प्रिय से मिलने के लिए लाल रंग का वस्त्र पहन करके जाती है। ये जो पुष्पागम है कल्पांत तक आपका मंगल करे ऐसी कवि कामना कर रहे हैं और कह रहे हैं कि यह श्रृंगार दीक्षा का गुरु है मलय पवन प्रवाहित हो रहा है कोकिला लाप सुनाई दे रहा है कोयल ही इस ऋतु में चारण है आम्र मंजरियां फूली हुई है भ्रमर पंक्तियां जो कि वसंत के धनुष की प्रत्यंचा है और जो चंद्रमा है वह निष्कलंक है इस ऋतु में वह मानो इस वसंत का श्वेत छत्र है संपूर्ण प्रकृति उल्लास से परिपूर्ण है ऐसा संसार को जीत लेने वाला वसंत से युक्त जो कामदेव है वह आप सभी का मंगल करें। अस्मिन् वसंतोत्सवे अहमपि एतदेव कामये सर्वेषां कृते वारं वारं धन्यवादान् विज्ञापयामि कार्तज्ञं च विज्ञापयामि यत् अस्मिन् कार्यक्रमे भवन्तः माम् आहूतवन्तः भूयो भूयो धन्यवादाः।
धन्यवाद मानव। If winter comes, can spring be far behind? The eternal cyclical nature of life comes across in the form of death and life, decline and progress, which go hand in hand, like autumn and spring, like the unison of Shiva and Vishnu. So the moral is, no winter lasts forever, and no spring skips its turn. The philosophical exaltation of destructive power of west winds, which has the seeds of reconstruction, is shared with us by Prakriti Vahane, who recites the poem An Ode to West Wind, written by P.B. Shelley. Over to you, Prakriti.
Respected teachers, audience, and my dear friends, today I'm going to recite a poem, Ode to the West Wind by P.B. Shelley. O wild west wind, thou breath of autumn's being, thou, from whose unseen presence the leaves dead are driven, like ghosts from an enchantry fleeing, yellow and black and pale and hectic red, pestilence-stricken multitudes, O thou, who chariotest to their dark wintry bed the winged seeds, where they lie cold and low, each like a corpse within its grave. Until thine is your sister of the spring shall blow her clarion over the dreaming girls, and fill, driving sweet buds like flocks to feed in air, with living hues and odors plain and hill. Wild spirit, which art moving everywhere, destroyer and preserver, hear, oh hear. Make me thy lyre, even as a forest is. What if my leaves are falling like its own? The tumult of thy mighty harmonies will take from both a deep autumnal tone, sweet though in sadness. Be thou, spirit feels, my spirit, be thou me, impetuous one. Drive my dead thoughts over the universe like withered leaves to quicken a new birth. And by the incantation of this verse, scatter, as from an unextinguished hearth, ashes and sparks. My words among mankind, be through my lips to unawakened earth, the trumpet of a prophecy, O wind. If winter comes, can spring be far behind? Thank you so much.
You can cut all the flowers, but you cannot stop spring from coming. Spring will come, and so will happiness. Hold on, life will get warmer. So experience the pure delight and profound beauty fragranced with the imagery of Vasant in the poem Spring, written by Sarojini Naidu and being recited by Shelley Sharma.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm going to recite the poem Spring, written by the Nightingale of India, Miss Sarojini Naidu. She says that young leaves grow green on the banyan twigs and red on the peepal tree. The honey birds pipe to the budding figs and the honey blooms call to the bee. Poppies squander their fragile gold in the silvery aloe break. Coral and ivory lilies unfold their delicate lives on the lake. Kingfishers ruffle the feathery sedge, and all the vivid air thrills with butterfly wings in the wild rose hedge and the luminous blue of the hills. Thank you. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Dinesh Shukla ne likha, कौन रंग फागुन रंगे रंगता कौन बसंत प्रेम रंग फागुन रंगे प्रीत कुसुम्भ बसंत चूड़ी भरी कलाया खन के बाजू बंद फागुन लिखे कपोल पर रस से भीगे छंद। दूसरी ओर एक भाव ये भी है वही आदर्श मौसम और मन में कुछ टूटता सा है अनुभव से जानता हूं कि ये बसंत है। रघुवीर सहाय की इन पंक्तियों में बसंत है, प्रेम है, विरह है, बस यही बसंत है, यही इश्क है। डॉक्टर पाखुरी वक्त जोशी, जो इस महाविद्यालय की पूर्व छात्रा है और जोशी कोचिंग क्लासेस की निदेशक है, उनसे सुनेंगे उनकी लिखी कविता बस यही इश्क है।
बहुत शुक्रिया ऊर्जा जी, मुझ खाकसार को इस अवसर पर याद करने के लिए आप सभी का मैं तहदिल से शुक्रगुजार हूँ। मैं हूँ एक विनम्र पाखुरी, जिस विराट सारस्वत उपवन की उस महकते गुलशन का बासंती संदेशा आया है। मेरी प्यारी दीदी ने आज मुझे बुलाया है, बासंती कविता का है आदेश। आ रहा याद अपने कॉलेज का सतरंगी परिवेश, वर्षों जहां कभी लहराया था ममता का आंचल, बिछा था कभी जहां पूजा संग मेरी तरुणाई का कोमल मखमल। आ रहा याद पल प्रतिपल, कुछ सुना हुआ, कुछ देखा हुआ, कुछ जो हुआ, कुछ जो ना हुआ, कुछ हुआ, कुछ अंश हुआ, मन में बासंती उमंग, शशि का निखिल संग, नलनी की राजनीति का पाठ, कभी सावन कभी बसंती ठाट, प्रभा का गर्वीला इतिहास, मन का हिलोरा लेता विश्वास, अर्थ की मरुभूमि में जहां किसी मूर्ति ने सुधारस बरसाया, कभी किसी पद्मा, किसी अजीता या अर्चना ने कितनी शकुंतलाओं के लिए मंगलाचरण गाया, जिस कुलगुरु में किसी गर्वीली शत्राणी ने असंख्य पुत्रियों को अपना सरल स्नेह था लुटाया, सुषमा संग ब्राउनिंग का आशावाद दोहराया, कभी कीट्स कभी शैली का काव्य संवाद दोहराया, ये उनकी याद का पावन दिन है, विद्या का ये बागीचा कितना कम सिन है, उनकी पवित्र स्मृति को अनंत प्रणाम, उन तक पहुंचाना ओ बसंत मेरा ये पैगाम। बाहर बसंत है, भीतर तपन ही तपन है, बाहर गुलशन है, मन में झुलसन है, फिर भी ऊर्जा संग कुछ कर गुजरने की लगन है। मेरी प्यारी दीदी तुम्हें नमन है, नमन है। सब कुछ के बावजूद मन सरसाया है, मेरे कॉलेज से संदेशा आया है, मन में बासंती गुनगुनाए, लो बसंत आया है। बहुत शुक्रिया।
Beautiful recital. The day God created hope, the same day he created spring, and the same day he created cloud as the agent of the cycle of life, whose parents are water and earth, and sky is the nurse. The cloud, which supports the system of life ceaselessly and in a number of ways, bringing about growth and change in the nature for the essence of life. Let's hear the feelings of the personified cloud by Zainab Safi, who's going to recite the poem The Cloud, written by P.B. Shelley. Zainab.
Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Zainab Safi, from MA previous year, and I'm going to recite a poem, The Cloud, from P.B. Shelley. I bring fresh showers for the thirsty flowers from the seas and the streams. I bear light shade for the leaves when laid in their noonday dreams. From my wings are shaken the dews that waken the sweet birds, every one. When rocked to rest on their mother's chest, as she dances about the sun, I wield the flail of the lashing hail and widen the green plains under. And then again, I dissolve it in rain and laugh as I pass in thunder. I am the daughter of earth and water and the nursling of the sky. I pass through the pores of the ocean and the shores. I change, but I cannot die. For after a rain, with never the stain, the pavilion of heaven is bare. And the winds and sunbeams with their convex gleams build up the blue dome of air. I silently laugh at my own cenotaph, and out of the cavern of rain, like a child from the womb, like a ghost from the dawn, I arise and unbuild it again. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Over to you.
Thank you, Zena. The earth laughs in flowers and spring laughs in daffodils, which provide a delightful spectacle and a nostalgic memory of this mesmeric beauty that can create spring in solitude anytime. That is the healing and refreshing power of nature. That is the power of spring. Let us feel this captivating experience in the recital of the poem Daffodils of Wordsworth by Miss Ayuchi Ahuja.
Good afternoon, everyone. Myself Ayushi Ahuja here, and I am going to recite a poem on daffodils by William Wordsworth. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high o'er vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils. Beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze, continuous as the stars that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way. They stretched in never-ending line along the margin of a bay. 10,000 saw at a glance, tossing their heads in sprightling dance. The waves beside them danced, but they outdid the sparkling waves in glee. A poet could not but be gay in such a jocund company. I guessed and guessed, but little thought what wealth the show to me had brought. For oft when on my couch I lie in vacant or in pensive mood, they flash upon that inward eye, which is the bliss of solitude, and then my heart with pleasure feels and dances with the daffodils. Thank you so much.
But today, when the poor farmers' suicides also don't cast any impact on people whose life is a song of spring, the sensitive empathy of a poet for the melancholy of a girl singing and binding crops in the field goes beyond dialect, time, and spring songs of cuckoo, and echoes even today in our festival in the voice of Miss Trishala Pathak, a student of MA English first semester, who is reciting William Wordsworth, The Solitary Reaper.
A very pleasant afternoon, everyone. So here goes the recital of The Solitary Reaper by William Wordsworth. Behold her, single in the field, yon solitary Highland lass, reaping and singing by herself. Stop there, or gently pass. Alone she cuts and binds the grain and sings a melancholy strain. Oh, listen, for the vale profound is overflowing with the sound. No nightingale did ever chaunt more welcome notes to the weary bands of travelers in some shady haunt among Arabian sands. A voice so thrilling ne'er was heard in springtime from the cuckoo bird, breaking the silence of the seas among the farthest Hebrides. Will no one tell me what she sings? Perhaps the plaintive numbers flow for old and happy far off things and battles long ago. Or is it some more humbly familiar matter of today? Some natural sorrow, loss or pain that has been and may be again. Whate'er the theme, the maiden sang, as if her song could have no ending. I saw her singing at her work and o'er the sickle bending. I listened, motionless and still. And as I mounted up the hill, the music in my heart I bore. Long after it was heard no more. Long after it was heard no more. Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you, Trishna. With this, we end the recitation session on an optimistic note through a verse of Kumar Vishwas. Tufani lehre ho, ambar ke pehre ho, purva ke daman par, daag bahut gehre ho. सागर के मांझी मत मन को तू हारना जीवन के क्रम में जो खोया है पाना है पतझर का मतलब है फिर बसंत आना है नाउ वी हैंड ओवर द फेस्टिवल स्ट्रिंग्स अगेन इनटू द हैंड्स ऑफ द कॉम्पियर डॉक्टर निरंजना मालनी नमस्ते
Thank you very much, sir, and Ulja. I extend a heartfelt thanks to all the contributors for the nice poetry which took all of us into a different world. I am happy to share that the YouTube comment box is flooding with words of appreciation for your deliberations. Now, we have come to the most important part of our program. And for this, I invite the webinar convener, Dr. Hemant Gehlot, Head, Department of English, IQAC member, and the officiating principal today, to give us a presidential address and obelage. Over to you, sir.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, I'm with you. And this time, of course, the portfolio is a little bit added to the previous one. Earlier, I talked to you as the convener with regard to the concept note. This time, I'm wearing another shoes, and this time, as officiating principal of the Girls College, I wish to present to you the presidential address, which is once again not just a formality but also a necessity. The Spring Festival has been a pioneer event which adhered to the academic norms as well as allowed room to entertain the audience with beautiful poetic recitations. Most of my feelings with regard to the organization of the festival have been already expressed in my concept note. This is another role wherein I'm trying hard to fit in. So on behalf of the administration of the college, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to the PG Department of English and IQSC, along with Tapancharya Foundation, for making this event a wonderful experience. The Government Girls College of Jain is known for its cultural and literary standards ever since its inception. And every year, the color and grandeur of those norms have increased manifold. The Spring Poetry Festival is a unique event in the sense that it has not only attempted to bring forth the lyrical quality of the compositions, but also incorporated the linguistic varieties of English, Hindi, and Sanskrit too. It was a feast to the eyes and the ears both that will stay in the memory long after it is declared over. The varieties of poems in Hindi by Dr. Shashi Joshi and Dr. Pankhari Vakht was a mesmerizing experience, no doubt, but the rhyme and lyricism of poems by Dr. Pratiksha Pawar and Dr. Vrinda Pawar, who carried on the legacy of their phone teacher, Professor La David, was an unforgettable moment of the event. Dr. Pooja Upadhyay's Sanskrit recitation was once again a very pleasant experience and a novel one as well. I am sure most of us have never heard such a lyrical and musical recitation of Sanskrit verses before. This is, even for most of us, the first time that we have amongst us an ardent scholar of Sanskrit. They all deserve our sense of gratitude for their active and creative participation. Coming to the students of this college, it's once again a very soothing experience and also quite an assuring one that there is ample potential in them which needs to be groomed, which needs to be increased as time passes and as they are accompanied by their teachers. This is the first time for them, and sure, there must have been certain loopholes, some mistakes committed by my dear students, but this is what is the learning moment of them. I extend my heartfelt thanks to Aishi, Shali, Trishla, Prakriti, and Zainab. And I also appeal to them to introspect and try to develop the qualities which they possess so far, but were not aware of. A bright future awaits them with fame and name both. I shall be failing in my duties if I do not mention the Faculty of English Department, Dr. Bharati Srivastava, Dr. Seema Sharma, and Dr. Niranjana Malani, who had been working for days together in the preparation of this spring festival, spring poetry event. Dr. Neeta Thapan has been instrumental in bringing everything to shape, and her round-the-clock concern and constant chilling had been the backbone of the festival. A big thanks to her for always cooperating and promoting best practices in the institution. We were fortunate in having with us two fundamentally dynamic masters of ceremony, Mr. Nitin David and Ms. Urja, whose awesome presence added grace and grandeur to the to this magnificent spring poetry festival. Their extempore comments bear virtue and vitality that is unsurpassed. We owe a lot of them for the success of this event and extend our heartfelt thanks for their invaluable contribution. Finally, all the students' fraternity who is on the other side of the event, watching, commenting, and encouraging us all, deserve a huge amount of gratefulness. Their live presence proved the liveliness of the spring in all its manifestations. Keep the great work going. With these words, I conclude and hand over the session back to Dr. Malani for further proceedings. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Thanks, sir, for your kind words of wisdom. Now, in the end, I request Dr. Bharati Srivastava, Professor of English, Government Girls PG College, Ujjain, to extend the word of thanks. Over to you, ma'am.
Good afternoon, everyone. Gratitude is the fairest blossom which springs from the soul. So at the outset, I, on behalf of English Department, IQSE and Thapan Chore Foundation, extend my deepest sense of gratitude towards our invited guests, contribution and alumni of Government Girls PG College, Ujjain. I thank Ms. Pratiksha Pawar, Dr. Shashi Joshi, Dr. Pooja Upadhyay, Ms. Vrinda Pawar and Dr. Pankhuri Bhak Joshi for adding color and fragrance to our poetry festival commemorated in the fond memory of Professor Sarla David, who served this institution from 1962 to 1993. In the same breath, I would thank our student, Ms. Prakriti Vahane, Shaili Sharma, Zainab Saifi, Ayushi Ahuja, and Trishla Pathak for adding sunshine to this spring festival with their joyous and enthusiastic contribution. I am thankful to Mr. Nitin David and Ms. Urja Tapan of Tapan Chore Foundation for their enthralling hosting of the poetry recital session. I thank our patron and principal in her absentia, who is away in a meeting, Dr. Anita Manchandia, for motivating us to organize this unique online festival. I also thank our officiating principal, convener of the event, and head of English department, Dr. Hemant Gehlot, for organizing this poetry festival. I thank our IQSE coordinator, Dr. Neeta Tapan, for conceptualizing this event and having set the ball rolling. I thank organizing committee member, Dr. Seema Sharma, for her cooperation. I also thank Dr. Niranjana Malani for conducting this program. I thank Tapan Chore Foundation for associating with us. Last but not the least, I am grateful to all the participants who joined us and made this event successful. With this, we come to the end of Poetry Festival. Thank you for joining us. Thank you.